bringing animals back, I do a lot of walking and a lot of trotting and long trotting. Really, I'm not concerned about the lope. If they want to lope, great. But the horse doesn't build up his lungs and he doesn't work his entire body like he would at a trot. Okay, kind of in analogy for what I've been told, a long trot is like you and I jumping in the swimming pool and starting to make laps. You use your whole body when you're swimming. The long trotting, they use a lot more muscles than they do when they're loping. Well, we got to make a big circle. We're not like the show in the Western where you lope and lope and lope. You don't lope your horses, you long trot them. It's easier for them to breathe that way. They're stretching out their muscles. And you cover a lot of ground with the long trot. If they want to buck and kick and play a little bit, that's one thing. But I don't sit here and drive and drive and drive. You know, old school analogy, lope them for 15 one way, 15 the next. Now that's by the wayside for me anyway. I do a lot of long trotting. We rehab lots of horses. And what's interesting is the horses that are long trotted, they have way more stamina. They're a whole lot more flexible. And they're better balanced conformation wise. So we long trot, just straight up. Now again, like Zip, he hasn't been out for a while. If he wants to run a buck and you know, play around a little bit, I'm gonna let him. Now, if you notice, we've been getting a lot of rain. Got quite a bit of rain last night. Chris and I are working horses in between breaks with storms right now. Now, if he was running and bucking and kicking, obviously I'm not gonna let him keep doing it, you know, to the point where he endangers himself, all right? The footing in here is good. It's solid, it's sound. But obviously we don't want to, what? Have him slip, bow a tendon, pull a hamstring, okay? Those things, they take a while to heal from. Oh man, that's okay. Go along in the process, and I'll put the butt rope on him. And again, what does that do? Gets his hind end up under him. Also, what's it do? Helps set his headset, and it builds his core. Horses that are hollowed out in the back, they don't build top line. It's very difficult to get top line built up on the horse. Conformation. If I take the front feet and the rear feet and bring them together like this, what's that doing with the back? Rounding the back out, ain't it? Well, what happens when we round the back out? We build the top line. So this right here, this actually is way more beneficial for him right here doing this than it is to be bucking and kicking and or say 15 minutes on the clock and you got to go low. Heart rate up, have him breathe, let him play a little bit, you know, reassociate what's happening. As you can tell, you know, he's not lean by no means. have to remember too is these horses that are bred to go, they're bred to do things, okay? This horse, he gets bored really quick of circles. It doesn't matter if I'm in here or in the arena pad. What he really likes to do is he likes to go chase cows. He loves roping cows. It gives him a job. And so this kind of stuff in here, he doesn't understand why he has to make, you know, 20 circles in a sense, or why he has to go for 15 minutes or 20 minutes. So what we do have to do is we kind of have to balance that. So a lot of times, you know, obviously I'll do disengagements and that kind of thing, okay? Especially once we get up and running here. But he does get to the point where he gets tired of it. He'll literally just stop and face up and say, you know, let's at least go out on the trail. And, you know, and then he'll get a burst of energy, play on the trail.